Hi, Tony Kashawi here with the weekly What's On. It's Friday. I just made it. What is it? At about 6:20 in the evening, Friday the 2nd. And we've got a busy week coming up. But instead of me listing all of the events that are happening, I recommend you go to the What's On Facebook page, the What's On in Gympie website, and have a look what's going on this weekend, because I'm going to use this announcement today to show you an interview that I did with Lin Sutherland. Now, she's a filmmaker that's coming to Gympie. Now, this is on the 22nd of November. Just let me read you the press release, because I think this is a very important event that's coming to Gympie. And I think, I believe that I really want to make sure that everyone knows this film is coming and that we should all turn up and watch this film, because it's a premiere. In other words, this filmmaker has decided to come to Gympie and launch the film here. There's a lot of people on the Sunshine Coast saying, well, what are you going to Gympie for? And it's Donna Leigh Connections, who wants to bring films to Gympie. She calls them films that matter. At least once a month, she's going to be bringing him to the Civic Center. And this one is going to be a premiere. So it's on its tour, on its way up the coast, and they've chosen Gympie. Now, I had a chance to speak to Lin. Lin's going to come up, and there's going to be Q&A, you know, at the showing at the Civic Center. And I'll just read a little bit of an introduction for you. So Lin Sutherland's reputation in the environmental conservation space has seen her become Australia's leading natural documentary producer. She has completed 65 environmentally based TV shows, each having aired to commercial audiences throughout networks like Channel 9, Discovery, national networks, USA, NZ, Russia, Asia, Europe, South America, and also showing her series. I'll just show you a bit of a poster of the Beauty and the Reef is the name of the film that's coming up. And it says here, the most important story in 65 million years, a film that must change a nation with 10,000 dives to tell the story. So this film takes us on a journey of the world's largest ecosystem and the fight to save the barrier reef. Okay, so what I'd like to do is show you the interview that I pre-recorded earlier. Well, actually, it was yesterday, earlier yesterday. So I'm hoping that you might watch this and share this with people who you think might want to attend the showing. Okay, so let me just do my What's On intro. Okay, we're starting. We've got Lin Sutherland on a Skype call with us here today. So, Lin, just a short introduction. You are bringing to Gympie via, is it Donna Leigh, of course. We should mention Donna. She's going to be bringing lots of movies. The Australian premiere screening of Beauty and the Reef. Can you tell us a little bit about it? Because you're going to be there, aren't you?
Yes, I'm coming to Gympie because I hear it's an amazing place to come and visit.
Yes,
and,
yes, it is.
I'm coming to Gympie because Donna has invited me as a filmmaker with a very important film, and she's very keen to show the people of Gympie what is happening with the environment and what's going on with the environment and kind of bring the community together. So I feel privileged that I can come to Gympie and show this film to a community that really wants to engage in looking for better ways forward.
Okay, and it's Beauty and the Reef. So it's what is it about? Why should people come?
Well, Beauty and the Reef, I guess, is all about our beautiful reefs because, you know, the biodiversity hotspots of the planet are the rainforest and, of course, the reef. So you've got most of your epicenters of life just in these two ecosystems globally. And although they only take up a few percent of the ocean floor, they really are home to most of the marine life. I mean, yes, there's lots of marine life in the big ocean, but the reefs are something very, very special. So I love reefs because I'm a diver, and I've been diving reefs all around the world, and I just wanted to do a film dedicated to our coral reefs and tell everybody the true story about what's happening with our reefs and really engage people in wanting to do something to bring our beautiful reefs back to their former glory.
Yeah, you were talking about before saying that there's a lot of films out there that are pretty depressing because it's saying how bad things are. But you say your film has actually got some things that we can actually do about it. Is that right?
Yeah, well, I mean, the film's a leveller. So when you come to the film, it won't leave you guessing what's happening. And I actually encourage people to come to the film and shed a tear, you know, feel a little bit of loss. It's not a kid's, you know, fairy tale. This is true life. And there will be sadness along with that. It's like, you know, when you lose a loved one and something like that, you've got to go through a grieving process. And I think the film allows people to see what's happening with our reef, but it tells them all the pieces to the puzzle so they understand. But it's such a big ecosystem, and it's such a beautiful ecosystem that I hate it when people say there's nothing we can do. I say, no, 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 this is where we've got to start doing everything that we can do. And I think that's the big difference about this film. It's not putting smokescreen that this isn't happening, but what it's saying is, well, you know, with this happening, we've got to feel the loss, but we really got to find it in our souls and in our hearts and in our minds to really engage and pull together and bring back this beautiful environment that we're actually losing.
So you're saying that this is the Australian premiere screening here in Gympie. We're pretty lucky, but where else is it going? Where else is it being screened?
Well, I've got, I'm just working on a few communities close to my home. So I live in the southern Gold Coast. So I'm working with Donna and a few other people close to me to put on some really big events for our local communities and the Gympie local community. And then we're looking at travelling up the Queensland coast and going nationally around Australia. We're already talking to people in Perth. We're talking to people in Townsville, Cairns, Melbourne, Victoria, Hobart. And I even in December will probably end up in Bali and Singapore to help promote awareness over there. They've just had an ocean conference over there, and it's then my job to go over there and help the communities come up with strategies and ways forward. So this film has really been designed to go international. I don't want it to stop at any boundary. There's reefs all around the world. There's forests all around the world. The film is, although it's called Beauty in the Reef, it doesn't ignore that all our ecosystems are connected. So we talk about the forest. We talk about, you know, all the connections of the ecosystem. And, of course, then we showcase our beautiful reef. And the highlight is, of course, the Great Barrier Reef, the world's largest reef.
Okay, and so you're going to be there. You're going to come up. It's I should tell everybody, it's on the 22nd of November, and it's going to be at the Gympie Civic Centre in the Heritage Theatre on the big screen, and we're going to have a Q&A after the film, and you're going to be there, is that right? Do you know who else is going to be on the panel?
No, we haven't released the exact people on the panel just yet. I do believe there'll be people from waste management. We'll probably get a marine biologist there. We will probably engage some of the local Gympie experts that have some great answers. We'll have some earth soil technicians that are there, we hope. If they come up, they'll be there to talk about how we can return our soils kind of feed our earth again, because there's many answers here, and that's why we're trying to have people. There'll be chemical experts there, so we can actually educate communities in their little bit about what they can do in their own, you know, not putting chemicals down their sinks, what they can do in their own backyard, and what they can do to help save the reef, even in choice of sunscreens and stuff like that. So
okay, so it's going to be a big event.
I hope so.
Yeah, no, I think this is very, very important. And I'm going to do my best to try and let everyone know in Gympie, because that's what I do. I got a What's On in Gympie. Everyone's watching it from the What's On. So to help, what's it cost? $15 a ticket. And also, was it kids under 7 free, children $10. Yeah. And we're going to be giving away some tickets as well. So we're going to be running a competition. So I'll put all the details at the bottom of this post. So, Lin, I think it's fantastic. I'm really glad that you are friends with Donna, and Donna's now living in Gympie, and she's bringing these kinds of films to us.
I think a lot of these passionate people from the environmental sector, a lot of the people grew up on the Great Barrier Reef. So, you know, we all saw the reef, absolutely stunning. 15 years ago, like, the reef was just incredible. 20 years ago, it was phenomenal. You know, I started diving when I was pretty young, so I got to see a whole spectrum of reef. I've worked with people like Valerie Taylor and Ron Taylor. You know, I've worked with some of the leading underwater cameramen, the leading filmmakers. I've worked with the leading marine biologists. And everybody in this environment has known this story for a very long time. It's actually nothing new, but it's accelerated to an urgent stage here. And I think that's why I want people not to feel bad that there's nothing they can do, not to put their heads in the sand, but to dig deep in their hearts and know that, you know, we can either love the reef to death or love it to life. And I'd like to think that we love it to life.
Yes, that sounds good. So, that sounds wonderful. Well, thanks for talking to me. And I'll see you, and hopefully you'll see most of Gympie there on the 22nd of November.
I look forward to it, Tony. I really do.
Oh,
I hope all of Gympie comes out. If, you know, if they're struggling, tell them to reach out. We want them all there. We don't want anyone to miss out.
That's a great call out. Thank you very much, Lynn. Bye-bye.
Thanks, Tony. Bye.
So there we have it. That was a pre-recorded interview with Lin Sutherland, bringing beauty and the reef. Now, you heard me say that there's going to be a competition to give away two double passes. So what we want to do is that we've created a competition where you can spread the word, and we'd like to reward people for their efforts. If you're going to get on there and share and you know, get likes and so on, we want to offer something. So two double passes, and the competition is you know, sharing and visiting the website. There's a few other tasks you can do, and you can collect points by doing this. And if you share it and somebody else joins the competition, you get extra points. So the person with the most points, the most effort put in sharing, will get the double pass. Yeah, so there's two places to win. So hopefully you'll do that, because I think this is an important film. Not just the fact that it's traveling around the countryside and seeing it, but it's actually coming to Gympie and it's the premiere. I think we've been chosen. We've been chosen as the special ones. So let's rise to the occasion and hopefully turn up and join Lynn on the day, 22nd of November. And doors open at 6 p.m., film at 6:30, Q&A 7:30, and you can see all the links will be at the bottom of this post, where to buy tickets. It's using I Want a Ticket, and it's got a link to the film trailer, so you can go and watch that and see what the film's about yourself. So that's all from me. As always, like and share the What's On in Gympie. We've actually celebrating 5,000 followers. So, in fact, it's 5,010 to this time and date right now. So thank you for everyone who has been following and liking the What's On. And I'll say goodbye. Ciao.